biggest fear is going to sleep at night and not waking up in the morning. When I lay down, my weight pushes pressure on my chest and on my lungs. So it is difficult to breathe. So I'm very scared to go to bed at night, especially knowing my kids are right there. I don't want them to wake up and me not wake up. I live with just my kids, but my mom and stepdad come over just about every day to help me do what I need to do.
Yeah, I don't know how much syrup you want on there.
I'm constantly thinking about food.
There you go.
I love just how delicious it tastes, how happy it makes me feel, how like it melts away my thoughts. It brings me to life when I eat. It makes me forget about the bad parts at that moment, just for that little bit of time. And it did the same for when I was younger as well.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh.
How y'all doing?
Good.
Good.
Good. All right, you must be Stephanie.
Yes.
All right, and this young person is who?
My stepdad.
Your stepdad?
Yes.
So what brought you down to Houston?
Hopefully for help getting my weight down and getting healthy again.
What do you mean healthy again? You were healthy before?
I wasn't this big. I was able to move around and walk more and...
All right. On a typical day, what do you eat?
Just whatever I can get, I guess. I mean... For dinner, I'd have a big plate of spaghetti.
Well, from the time you wake up, what time you wake up?
I wake up usually at 8 every morning with my kids.
Okay. So what do you eat at that time?
I eat with my kids usually. I'll have just a bunch of eggs and sausage, sometimes pancakes.
Okay. And so what do you drink in the morning?
Chocolate milk, juice, sometimes
chocolate
soda.
Chocolate milk and juice.
Yeah.
Those are high-calorie drinks.
Yeah.
Okay, then after that, what do you eat?
When my kids are at school, I'll snack and I'll eat like
snack
sandwiches or I'll snack on cupcakes and chips.
Who buys those cupcakes and chips?
I send either my stepdad or my son to the store, sometimes my mom. I write a list and they go and buy me what I usually want.
Okay, so your son or your stepdad will go get what you order.
Yeah.
Okay, so they're your enabler. So how are we gonna break that cycle of being everybody supporting your eating habit?
I'm gonna have to change it. They're gonna have to tell me no.
If you keep this up, you know, you're going to hit 700 pounds, and after that, you're going to be bedridden, and then your health is going to go down really quick. So how motivated you are to change?
Extremely. That's why I'm here. I want to change.
What do you do all day? Do you work?
No, I'm usually just at home watching TV, which, you know, I don't want to be able to go to work.
So right now, how are you supporting yourself?
I have my mom and my stepdad to support me right now.
How long have you been doing that?
A few years now.
All right. So you got the parents that are supporting your eating habit and everything else. So I don't see a whole lot of motivation to change.
I don't want my kids like me. So that's going to motivate me to change myself.
Why haven't done anything about it at this point?
I've tried. I don't think I quite understand, you know, size-wise, portion-wise. It's just something I just eat until I'm full.
So right now, I'm skeptical if you're going to change anything.
Okay.
And it's not that you just woke up and realized that your weight was your problem. You've known all along, but you haven't done anything about it. Nobody around you seems like is supportive of you to change. Everybody is supporting you to make you happy to eat what you want. And that's going to be a problem. So this is going to be a really difficult task for you and depend on how motivated you are and how hard you're going to try. I'm going to give you some information.
Okay.
And we're going to see if you can get some changes made on your eating habit. And if you do that, it'll work with you.
Okay.
But if you're not able to lose weight, then not much we can do for you. And we go from there, okay?
Okay.
You gotta feel the burn.
Hmm?
Feel the burn.
Do I juice out to the side?
That one you can also pass around like this, around your, to your backside.
Ouch.
That doesn't work?
No. At my last appointment, I was 602 pounds. Doctor Now gave me a goal of losing 50 pounds in 2 months. So if I did that today, I would be down to 552 pounds.
You want to step up on the scale?
Could have done better.
I don't understand. You've changed everything.
Okay. We're going to room 5.
Okay. That's really disappointing. I don't even know what to say. I mean, sure, I lost weight, so that's good. But you know Dr. Now is not going to see it that way. I just don't understand because of how hard I've been working. It doesn't make sense. It feels like something must be wrong. Because this doesn't add up.
Hello.
Hello.
How y'all doing?
Okay.
How was that trip down here?
It was long, exhausting, painful.
So was it easier than last time?
Kind of. It was shorter.
So you fly?
Yes, we flew.
How long a flight is that?
How long did we fly? I think it was 4 hours.
4 hours. A little over four hours total.
Okay. All right, so what's going on with you and your eating habit?
I'm trying. I've been trying new things, new healthier options. I think I'm still slipping up a little bit, but I've been trying.
Well, you haven't lost much weight this time, huh?
No, I'm disappointed in myself for that.
So what's going on with that?
I'm not sure. I mean, I'm trying to do, you know, the best I can.
And we haven't done anything to move down to Houston either, huh?
No, I'm working on that. I have to make phone calls and stuff.
And at this point, with all this trip you're making down here, I feel like you're really not as serious about changing your life. So, you know, you need to get your line of thinking to the point that, hey, I'm going to do this, and it's my responsibility to do that, and not to expect that you come here and make you lose weight.
Right.
You know, it really, after all this time, I think this is your really last chance to make the changes and show your commitment to your health and your future. What I want to do is make arrangement for you to see a local clinic.
Okay.
When you go there, check your weight and see what your progress is doing. I'm going to set you another goal of losing 50 pounds in next 2 months. And if you make progress in the future, then we can consider it moving to Houston, but at this point, it's like far away from weight loss surgery, okay?
Yeah.
So in the meantime, if you need any help or anything else, give me a call.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
Bye.